I'm Kevin Hogan with Rock Island Auction Company, and I'm standing here today with Andrew Padovich, one of our senior firearms describers here at Rock Island Auction Company. We're here today to tell you about our upcoming September 7th, 8th, and 9th Premier Firearms Auction. We've called this sale our most anticipated auction in our company history, and for good reason. The bulk of the sale is comprised of four major collections, all different in their scope, but share a common theme of high quality, rarity, and diversity. The first, the Gateway Collection, of rare Colt single actions, percussions, Winchesters, Smith & Wessons, and other early 18th and 19th century arms. The second, the William Ashby Collection, comprised of Derringers and early Marshall pistols. The third, the William Doc Janet Collection, of high condition, rare Civil War arms. And lastly, the Michael Barrett Collection, which is presented before us. Andrew has a master's degree in history and was tasked with seeing the collection through the auction process. Andrew, what can you tell us about the collection?
Well, the Barrett Collection is a spectacular collection of 19th century to early 20th century European helmets. Most of it is represented by the British. For example, we have a great showing of 17th Lancer items. This is just a small portion of what we have. There are over 100 different types of helmets in this collection.
As well as related accessories.
Accessories, yes, and well as medals as well. There's probably over 200, 300 medals.
Great.
Just in this auction alone. Again, the 17th is well represented in this auction. We have here is a belt top shako that dates back to when the Lancers were known as the 17th Light Dragoons. The Light Dragoons, what I find about their history is their connection to American history. Okay. They were here during the American War for Independence. They fought at the Battle of Bunker Hill and in the Long Island Campaign, and were later in the Southern colonies fighting different battles there, including the Battle of Cowpens, which is a well-known battle in the South. In the 1820s, the regiment became a Lancer regiment during a time when Lancers were popular within European militaries. What we have here is a very rare example of an early Lancer cap. They would later evolve over time to what we have here standing behind it, which is a early 20th century lance cap. It's an officer's cap. You can tell by the plate, which has a gilt-rayed background with the silvered regiment insignia along with the battle honors. If this was a other ranks cap, this would be one-piece gilt medal.
And what can you tell me about the 17th Lancers outside their expedition in the American Revolution?
Sure. They are one of the biggest battles that they participated in as a Lancer unit was at the charge of the Light Brigade. An ill-fated battle for British cavalry due to vague orders, miscommunication, the British attacked a Russian gun position. The Russians inflicted heavy casualties, including on the 17th. The 17th started the battle with around 140 members. Around 40 members were able to come back after the battle.
Pretty unbelievable.
That it is.
And with the collection, you mentioned Russian and the correlation here. Tell us about this.
This is an Imperial Russian Guard helmet that was used from the mid-1800s to prior to World War I. It's obvious by the big Imperial Russian eagle that's on top. It's in great condition. Rare to find it in this condition. If you do find it, usually something is missing from the eagle. The eagle is broken. It's something that you would expect to find in a Russian museum.
Wow.
And it can be all yours.
Only at Rock Island Auction Company. And tell me about this piece. It looks real similar, but I know you're going to tell me otherwise.
This is actually a Saxon heavy cavalry unit helmet that was introduced around 1907. It's a parade helmet, as you can tell by the lion crest. It could be removed for other reasons with the spike, and we do have that variation in this auction too.
Great.
We have both variations of this helmet.
And I guess last but certainly not least, tell me about this one over here.
This is a red Lancer cap from Napoleon's Imperial Guard. The Red Lancers fought against the Russians and were there during the Battle of Waterloo and actually escorted Napoleon off the battlefield after his defeat.
That's great. Only at Rock Island Auction can you find pieces such as this. Where else can you see items of this quality, rarity, and diversity outside of a museum? And it's all for sale this September 7th, 8th, and 9th. Be sure to check out our website, www.rockislandauction.com, and we hope to see you at the auction. Remember, it starts at 9 a.m. Hope to see you then.